Your Excellencies from the Royal Norwegian Government, especially Special Envoy Ambassador Elizabeth Slatum and her team of the facilitators, like Mirja. Compatriots in the Netherlands and the negotiating panels and delegations of the Government of the Republic of the Philippines and the National Democratic Front of the Philippines, esteemed guests, I think it is significant to note that the fourth round of formal talks in the GRP-NDFP peace negotiations opens on the heels of the 48th founding anniversary of the New People's Army. On March 29, just 4 days ago, the NPA, the Armed Forces of the Communist Party of the Philippines, which is an allied organization of the NDFP, marked its 48th year of revolutionary armed struggle. Today, we have new generations of Filipinos spread across the country, taking up arms to address the same basic problems that have haunted our history as a people: poverty, inequality, injustice, oppression. The resilience of the NPA is as much a testament to the inexhaustible participation and support of the people as it is an indictment of the failure of the system and its successive governments to address the social and economic roots of the armed conflict. This is why the NDFP negotiating panel comes to this fourth round of formal talks determined as ever to push and accelerate the negotiations in the hope of forging a comprehensive agreement on social and economic reforms by the end of 2017. The NDFP's chief political consultant, Professor Jose Maria Sison, has already raised key points of the comprehensive agreement on social and economic reforms of the CASER in relation to a roadmap for the peace process. I share Professor Sison's positive views and reiterate the wisdom of securing the approval of the CASER ahead of any single joint ceasefire agreement unless both agreements can be signed simultaneously. It is important to stress that this is the that as the issue of ceasefire should not be pursued as an end in itself. Ceasefires, whether unilateral, bilateral, or joint, are just a means to an end. Its main purpose is to create conditions conducive to reaching agreements on basic reforms that are satisfactory to both sides. However, let me note that the NDFP rules the GRP's sudden announcement not to restore its unilateral ceasefire, which is an unexpected departure from the March 11 back-channel agreement. Yet, the NDFP negotiating panel, in the spirit of flexibility and openness, desirous of fostering a positive climate for continuing the peace talks and building on the gains in the last 3 rounds, is willing to discuss with its counterpart what kind of bilateral ceasefire agreement is desired by the GRP in place of the unilateral ceasefire. The NDFP believes it is possible to have a bilateral ceasefire agreement that conforms to the position that simultaneous and reciprocal declarations of unilateral ceasefires can be agreed upon and bound by a memorandum of understanding that shall be issued at the end of the fourth round of formal talks. We trust and hope that our counterparts in the GRP side will be as open and resolute in addressing the long drawn out issues concerning the implementation of an already existing agreement, the Comprehensive Agreement on Respect for Human Rights and International Humanitarian Law. In relation to escalating militarization in the countryside, let me just note that 46 peasants have already been killed under the Duterte administration, according to the Luzon Magbubukid ng Pilipinas. 50% of these killings were perpetrated following the armed forces of the Philippines' implementation of an all-out war policy on February 2, or at the rate of one peasant killed every 2 days. On the other hand, the NDFP welcomes the progress made in the issue of compensation for victims of martial law and hopes that the process of indemnifying the victims can be further accelerated to ensure that justice is rendered to the victims. Before I end, on behalf of the NDFP panel, I sincerely thank the Royal Norwegian Government for its continuing and crucial support to the peace negotiations, especially as this took a difficult turn in the last 2 months. It was a wrenching experience for the MDMP consultants in the Philippines as they faced intensified harassment and imminent arrest, with one consultant actually being jailed. We commend the RNG for walking the extra mile to push the Box Channel Talks and to put the peace process back on track. Today, we welcome back arrested MDMP consultant Ariel Arbitrario. We look forward to fruitful discussions in the next 4 days in the common effort to find solutions to seal an enduring and just peace for our country through mutually acceptable comprehensive agreements on necessary reforms. Thank you and good morning.